Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2 Enhanced Edition. Lord Jirdan has an offer for us, if we wish to hear it. And I guess we do. Hail, Lord Jirdan. We're in the Copper Coronet, by the way.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
I am called Lord Jirdan Firecrack. And I bid you stand a moment and hear my offer.
Firecrack.
Word has come to me of your actions. I see you as capable and henceforth with the ability to handle what Harris knows. Just the type of creature that I am looking for.
Sorry, guys, it's so loud in here. You have done your research well. What do you need of me? Certainly you understand that these are dangerous times and that extreme measures are often called for. That is why I have need of you. I am a lord of a community outside Athkatla, and while I provide for my people as best that I can, there are some things I cannot do. Battle is not my strong point. They are marauders, horrid ogres and trolls that must be destroyed with fire or they regenerate. I need a firm hand to push them back. I need you, Sapphire. I offer a grand sum, worthy of a woman of your stature. I offer 10,000 gold if you can free my land of this scourge. It is a fortune, you will agree. Why me and not some other company? You could have anyone at that price. Ah, but you would not lump yourself together with common mercenaries, would you? No, I require someone with finesse and skill, as well as strength. You are ideal. You are the choice I make, and the offer stands whether you go now or not. There is no other decision that makes sense. Well, I have no doubt that your service will be exemplary. If all goes well, we shall all receive exactly what we deserve. My lands are on your map. The Windspear Hills await. Mintz says, "Ooh, to take swords against monsters of great evil?" Already I feel Boo wriggling in excited anticipation. Yoshimo, from all the way over there, says, "Are you sure you're talking about your rodent there, Minsk? Not a heart attack? I've seen you get pretty excited after all." "Of course it is Boo. Boo is always happy when opportunities for heroism come. We shall crush these ogres, and rangers and hamsters everywhere shall rejoice." Yoshimo says, "Well, I've heard of this Lord Jirdan Sapphire. If it's any help, he has the coin to back up his offer. He's not reputed to be the nicest noble in Am, but then, who is?" Chihiro says, "I think it would be an excellent idea to get outside of the city and administer justice on such evil creatures. Tyranny is best matched with equal force." Nalia says, I don't know, Jahira. I've heard about this Lord Jirdan. He's brutal. It's not like him to be so protective of his people. I don't like the sound of this. Huh. I was approached by a Lord Jirdan Firecrag, whose lands outside of Athkatla are being plagued by ogre bandits and trolls. He has asked that I journey to the Windspear Hills and kill these ogres, and has offered a 10,000 gold pieces reward for the deed. Ogres and trolls. Alright, well, we're not doing that yet either. So from here, the slums, we can go any of these places. We're going government next. I'm going to finish exploring the slums, though. So I'm not sure where this is on the map. Oh, all the way over here, Windspear Hills. Oh, there's Watcher's Keep. Can't really go down that far, but there it is. Oh, he disappeared, this guy? Garrel. Did we talk to him?
I need some ale.
Hey now! Brr. Morning, Lord's blessing, excuse me. I don't recognize you. My name is Minsk. Who might you be? Well, I be Garrel. Thank you. Brr. Who a shot. Now that you and I be proper friends and all, how about you buying Garrel a drink, eh? Here's 5 gold pieces, Garrel. I'm interested in hearing what's been going around here, if you know of it. Eh? Going, Sean? Oh, I be knowing, I certainly do. With all your generous coin, you be looking for some of Lieutenant's entertainment, aye? What kind of entertainment are you speaking of, Garrel? Well, dash depends on what kind of fun you ish looking for, aye? Lieutenant here, he serves all kinds, she does. The tavern drunk says, psst, Garrel, my friend, are you sure you should be talking about such things to strangers? Ah, I'm sure Lieutenant not be minding. Lieutenant, you serves all those who have coins aplenty, aye? He has grippers in the back, I hears to wagers on. Grippers? A real fight, wish blood and all. The tavern drunk says, Garrel, be wary. If the tavern drunk is telling you that, you really should listen. Aye. Mayhap you should be asking Lieutenant for yourself, if that's what you've been wanting. Brr. I have little enough coin myself to have ever indulged. Thank you for the information, Garrel. Here's an extra 5 gold for your troubles. Perhaps I'll go and talk to Lieutenant after all. Ah, you are ashamed you are. The more enlarged praise is upon you.
How can I help?
And this is how we play it, says Nalia. Yoshimo says, believe it or not, we are playing already. Can you play it for very long? Do not ask. Let us just find out. Even if we play all night or forever? For all things, there is an end, Nalia. Good. It will be a waste to spend the rest of our lives in this manner. Happiness is having a purpose in life. I don't think this is the best use of our time, Yoshimo. Yoshimo, just play and you'll begin to enjoy it. What are we playing? Tavern games? Okay, knowing you have some ulterior motive for making me play your game. Lest you forget, you are smiling even as you complain, Miss Dionys. They're playing some kind of game? Miss Dionys? I was Nalia a moment ago. Nobility comes with privileges. Only for those greedy enough to take them. Perhaps you play long enough, if you must doubt my sincerity. Quiet. I want to see this through to the end. Really? You were opposed to the whole notion of this diversion just a moment ago. Surely a lady is allowed to change her mind. True, but you are always so single-minded of purpose. Unless you care to explain that remark, I demand that you take it back. Very well. You have my apologies, Mr. Onis. Will you actually be able to think of a word for X, or do you surrender at last? Are they playing a word game? Zukuth is the drow word for heart. No luck for you, I fear. You cannot believe I would consider that fair. Zealot for fair play that I am, I would never cheat you. A likely story, but true. Can we declare a draw, Yoshimo? I'm starting to feel foolish. Draw, then. Even though it is an unsatisfying end to the game? For a treasured companion, no sacrifice is too great. Goodness. They're playing some kind of game. Alright, let's talk to Tiana, because why not?
You! Have you seen my husband? I know he's in here somewhere!
Who might I ask is your husband?
Rumar! Lord Rumar! You know who I'm talking about. Everyone here knows who I'm talking about. He's meeting her here again. Rumar's around here somewhere. No one will tell me where it is, but I'll get him and his cheap slattern, too. You hear that, Rumar? I will get you for this!
No, I don't know where he is.
I'll fight him eventually. I swear I'll fight him.
Okay. He's not happy.
You look like a good enough sort.
I wish my husband would finish with his amusements in the back. I tire of waiting. Alright. Talk to
my
these
time
guys.
Is quick, so be brief, commoner.
This sort of place would normally be beneath me, but it has some of the most wonderful entertainments, you see. if you know how to ask for them. Alright, let's talk to these guys. Durncrag.
Greetings, fellow adventurer. I was wondering if you might give my companions and I some assistance.
Do I recognize them? Are they the... Are they some of the... Dwargar from inside the dungeon? I'm gonna bet that they are. Say, hang on, I recognize you. Aren't you Durncrag? And that is a Faerûn over there. Yes, I am. Have you heard of our adventuring group? Kagoth says, huh? You know who we are? Okay, maybe it's not them. Aradin says, great, we're famous. Now, can we finally get some help? Durncrag says, yes, well, will you listen to our proposal? Okay, they weren't who I thought they were going to be. Okay, you have my attention.
Lord Thaddeus Leoncourt of Baldur's Gate has recently had one of his possessions stolen. He didn't say what it was taken, but it must be something of great value since he's offering a substantial reward for its return.
We've tracked the culprit to Om, but the trail's gone cold. We know that he was a shadow thief, and that he had a deal to unload the goods with one of the local fences, but we could not learn more. Shadow thieves do not like being questioned, and we do not have any other means of contact with them. Except for Castor here, but for some odd reason, he wouldn't even come close to their building. Don't ask, says Castor. Nalia says, shadow thieves, Sapphire. I do not like this. Jahira says, do you wish for our help then? Aerie says, of course we'll help, won't we, Sapphire? Min says, a chance to help fellow adventurers and strike the boot into the black heart of thieving evil again. Aradin says, yes, yes, I imagine you and Kagoth here will get along nicely. Huh? Says Kagoth. Exactly what I meant. Yes, well, we all know... All we know is the fence's name, Gruden. He should be somewhere around the docks or the slums, but we're having troubles locating him. If you could find this man and help us discover the whereabout of Lord Leonhardt's stolen item, we'd be happy to split the reward with you. But first you have to find Gruden. Return here when you have some news. It's a deal. Any idea why I should start looking for this man? Other than... the docks? Somewhere around the docks or the slums. I would ask around. The Shadow Thieves rule the docks, so their operation is centered there. But Gruden could be here, in the slums as well. I do not think he operates during the day, though. Good luck. Talk to me again if you find out anything new. Huh. Today I met Durncrag, a dwarven paladin, and his band of fellow adventurers in the Copper Coronet. They are looking for a treasure chest that was stolen from Lord Thaddeus Leoncourt of Baldur's Gate. A fence named Gruden may know something, but they are having difficulties locating him. Perhaps other fences will know where to find him. Once I locate him, I should return to Durncrag. Okay. Yeah, there was a fence we just... spoke to. Could ask him, maybe.
So, have you found anything?
Aradin says, yes, I was just wondering about that, actually. Well, that and how much ale it would take Kagoth to end up under the table.
Hey, this wasn't funny, you know,
Kagoth says. Whatever. So, do you have something to say? Not really. I'll get to you later. Very well, we shall be here. Great. Standing around, some more standing around. Patience is a virtue and all that. My day cheese just keeps getting better. Well, if you don't want to stand around, go look for the guy yourself. Then you'll be walking around. Can we talk to some of the other people? Castor?
Hey, beauty. I think your clothes would look really good in a crumpled heap on my bedroom floor.
Nice. Yeah. I don't agree.
You know? I think she may not like me.
Whatever gave her that idea? My god, gods, you are totally stunning even for an elf. Don't even look at Aradin over there. He is a bastard. Kagoth says, word. Word. Hey, says Aridin. So what are you doing tonight, says Caster. Ares says, keeping away from nasty scoundrels like you? Excuse me. Oh, well, you know, I've always had a thing for blonde half-elves. I thought he was talking about me, because I'm blonde. Perhaps you have a thing for a blade jammed down your throat as well, Jahira says. No. I'll be brief about this. You have gorgeous hair, I have gorgeous, everything. Shall we? No, says Nalia. Fine, but maybe, just maybe you could show me around? In your dreams and my nightmares, says Nalia. Right. So, look, you really have to talk to Durncrag, not to me. Kagoth?
So, have you found anything, folks? You should speak to Durncrag. He is in charge.
What do you want? Can't you see I'm busy?
It looks like you're just hanging around a bar doing nothing. And I'd like to get back to it if you don't mind. Is there any way I could persuade you to talk to me? 50 gold. Jahira says, the greed of city dwellers never ceases to amaze me, though I never thought to find it in an elf. Welcome to the real world, sweetheart. You may be content to live in the forest and subsist off a diet of berries and tree bark, but the rest of us need money. 50 gold for just a moment of your time? That's outrageous. Take it or leave it. Not a chance. Have it your way. I mean, we don't have that much money. Yeah, I guess we'll give him 50 gold. What the hell?
What do you want? Can't you see I'm busy?
Could you tell me a little about this place? Certainly, since I have nothing better to do with my precious time than answer your questions. Glad to hear it. So what can you tell me about this place? I see sarcasm is too subtle an art form for you to appreciate, so I'll be blunt. Go away. I'm not going anywhere. Fine. Lurk if you must. Just try and keep quiet while you're loitering about.
What do you want? Can't you see I'm busy?
Were you born this much of an ass, or did you have to practice? I practice being a bastard daily. It's my hobby. It was that or learning to play an instrument, and being a bastard is easier. What will it take to get you to answer some of my questions? This one, here's your money. Start talking. What can you tell me about this place? It's called the Copper Coronet. And? That's it. I've only just arrived here. Go talk to a local if you want more. Give me my money back. No. Cheap bastard. Always happy to be of service. Well, that was a waste. I just had to try, though. Surly?
Everyone here seems so unhappy and severe. I'm so unused to living this way. In the circus, we always were cheerful. Or at least Uncle Quail was determined to be.
He used to say that a frown would never get anything useful done. I think everyone could use some cheering up. What about you, Sapphire? Heh, you're probably right. If only things were so easy. Yes, I suppose your recent life would leave little to laugh about. One day this will be all over for you, Sapphire, and then maybe we can all laugh. Maybe. As for now, this guy is surly. Oh, Corgan. Sounds familiar.
What you want?
What is it, then? Surly is in no mood for churls today. Come back tomorrow.
What is it that you do here?
What does it look like? I'm a priest of Lathander, and this air's a devotion to the bloody Dawn Rabbits. Are you simple or something? Get out of my face.
Excuse me, you have no call to be so rude. I'm only asking a simple question.
That's because you're brain-addled. Surly isn't here to be pestered. Take a hike.
Okay, then.
what you want.
I want to sponsor a match. How much is it again? Or how much is it for the first time?
It's 10 gold. You get a dog. Yours fights one of mine. You win, you double your money. You lose your money. Now cough it up or get lost.
I'm not interested in sponsoring anything, although I probably will. I'm looking for answers. Okay, never mind. We'll come back to him. Corgan.
Drink hail, wassail for all. I be curious, friends. I'm scouring for a band of desperate men to aid me in a gallant task.
You look like you keep undertakers in a brisk trade. Have you courage and time for a tale?
We'll listen to your tale.
Belly up, comrades, and let Corgan flail the bladder for a spell. A fortnight passed, me fellows and I were in the midst of obtaining an ancient text for our patron when a skirmish visited our midst. Vile words, alas, became a lake of bloodshed. So it goes, the sacred grimoire never made it to our benefactor's hand. Now he awaits its arrival with a zeal reserved for a grog blossom and an ale keg.
Okay, a lot of zeal, I guess.
The scuttlebutt is the pay, his ansom. And worthy of note, sacks of loot and odd magics. The volume sits not far from here, and the bibliomaniac, he paces the floor in the meantime.
Who is this book collector? Why his interest in this particular time-worn manual?
Bimlico collects books just for the pleasure of collecting. Arcane, bizarre, peculiar, matters not. Upon hearing of a curious map, chart, or book, he travels countless leagues to obtain it, fearful of entrusting his commission to anyone else. This were his first outside hire. As for the book itself, it not matters to me what lays twixt its skins. I'll not risk knowing I've bled for Elminster's memoirs or a Dritz loblolly recipe. 'Tis called the Book of Kaza.
Where is the book, then, Corgan?
In some hobnail's tomb over in the lower crypts of the graveyard district. It's nigh abandoned, but rumors and half-truths only scare the young and infirm. Keeps the curious away, me guess.
Is there something we should know about this tomb?
Well, it'll take far more than a few shambling bags of skin and stitches to deter a Corgan blood axe from a king's ransom. A foolhardy jaunt into a hive of undead? How could you resist?
We're in the space in our party right now. We just took on this one here. We have no time at present, but may soon.
Fine then, Bowlhives. I'll be stirring dirt in the lavatory if you change your middling minds. Then about the tavern, should you ponder further.
Well, it doesn't add anything to our... I'll have to remember to come back here. Didn't add anything to our journal or anything. Okay. Alright, we talked to Surly, he's a ruffian.
I can break an arm or a leg for a couple or two.
He looks like a fancy one. That's what Amalas says he does. Well, there's Amalas. There's another ruffian.
Be off with you.
I don't like the bleeding look of you either. Think mighty highly of yourself, does you?
Amalas? I hit that right here again.
Stay back, or you'll regret it.
Get lost. Can't you see that I'm busy?
All right, then.
My time is quick, so be brief, commoner.
Have you seen that huge sphere? How absolutely dreadful. I seem to remember something about it. Some story about a wizard? Whatever. Patron here?
Stay back, or you'll regret it.
Oh, now Amalas talking to us again.
Oi, look at the dolly girl, all sacked up like an adventurer. Are you supposed to be tough or something,
I'm not here to impress you, sir. Hurl your insults elsewhere.
Oh, sir, is it? Haha, I was right, you're a bleeding coward. Admit it.
Watch it, you arrogant fool. Keep speaking to me in that tone, and you'll make me very angry. Oi, oi, that sounds like a blatant challenge, it does. I've no fear of you, dolly girl. How about it then, I? You want to fight? Wait, well, if it's a fight you want, I'll not back down from it. Here's that, boys. Looks like she wants to fight. Ruffian says, no one said she was smart, I. Ha! Yeah, you're the best, Amalas. Airy says, oh, Sapphire, is this really necessary? Can't you just ignore him? Amalas says, so be it. Hey, Surly. Surly says, what? What is it? I gots me here some gold for a fight. And a loser to be, sure enough. Wait, are we fighting or are we fighting with dogs? Bah! There's no need to yell so loud, idiot. Fine, fine, I'll have the bleeding pit all set up for you. Once I seize your gold, that is. All right then, friend. Let's step into the ring, shall we? Says Amalas. Am I fighting him by myself? I can't fight him by myself.
What?
He's banishing my... Yeah, I'm not really a good... Catch!
Yes, fine. What such menial tasks? What?
The mighty meteor's going.
Yes.
Almost got him. Cast it. Got him. Nice. Got a live experience there.
Nature's servant awaits.
What is it?
I think we're out of healing
you
spells.
Point. Yeah. I punch.
What? A simple matter.
I can't go in and loot him. Can't fast loot him either.
I'm watching you.
Stay back, or you'll regret it.
You killed Amalas, you bastard.
Stay back, or you'll regret it.
You killed Amalas. What am I gonna tell my mom? Your mom.
Swords, not words! Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle!
Okay, Suna Seni?
I've seen just about enough of you.
Well, she seems pretty. Well, she looks pretty. Is there something I can help you with, sir? Greetings, ma'am. What brings you to the Copper Coronet? If you must know, I am passing the time before my meeting with my employer. If you don't mind, I have much to think over, and would appreciate some solitude. If you're looking for entertainment, perhaps you should inquire with the barkeep. Okay. Joluv?
Well, you look like the sort who has more than two gold pieces to rub together.
Greetings, I am Joluv. I have recently arrived from the 10 towns of Icewind Dale. It was a long trek, but I wanted to get the most value I could from the items I had collected up north. Athkatla is known as the richest city in all of Faerûn, so I knew there would be adventures about with the amount of coin I was looking for. Would you like to take a look at my wares? Sure. Okay, you've got some stuff that I can't buy. Not even gonna look at it at this point. Alright, let's finish our tour of this place. Adelman is over here.
Fair lady.
Oh.
What brings you to this cesspool of corruption?
I seek adventure and honor. Chance smiles upon you, for I am an adventurer of some worth. I am Anuman, warrior priest of Helm. What is your name? Oh, this is Nalia talking. They're all selected, though. Do any romance not? I'm tempted to say that, but that is rude. I am Nalia. It is a pleasure to meet you. Perhaps I have found, perchance I have found worthy companions. I seek to be knighted in the most noble order of the Radiant Heart, and I must prove my worth first. Have you need of a strong warrior, my lady? Regretfully, I must decline your offer. So be it. If you seek to right the wrongs of this blighted land, then I am the man you should speak to. Methinks I shall still be here, searching in vain for adventurers of merit. Perhaps you will. Yeah, maybe we'll be back for him. Right now we're full. Can I take that? I guess that's a... Well, the dire wolf has been unsummoned. Tavern wench.
Why, you're all such big men.
The weather outside have been a mite terrible, aye? I hear it's from them bleeding wizards, that's what. Well, it could be. Not everything is the problem of wizards. Or the fault of wizards. Now, we spoke to this Tiana?
You!
I think so.
Have you seen my husband?
Yes.
I know he's in here somewhere!
Yeah, we definitely did talk to her. Alright. Let's talk to Salvanus.
Fair folk rarely have time for small talk.
Hmm? Ah, my apologies. I was distracted by the posterior of a most lovely woman over yonder. Okay. Unger Hildark. Cool name.
Your chattering's starting to wear on me nerves.
Don't be bothering me, little one. I'm not in a pleasured mood this morn. Alright, then Lieutenant, I suppose. Let's talk. Who's that? Patron. Yeah, let's talk to him and find out what these games are all about.
I would speak with you. I need help getting...
Okay. Bernard says, begging your pardon, ma'am. Hexad is harmless enough, but she can be a little uncoordinated. Is she all right? Those aren't exactly the words I would use, but I'm afraid she doesn't get much better than this. How so? She's in here every night. I should throw her out, but look at her. It'd be like kicking a sick dog. M'lady, are you all right?
Fine. I need to get to Dragomir's tomb in the district with the graves.
You wish to go to a tomb? Why?
Treasure. There's a great treasure there in Dragomir's tomb. Graveyard. Enter from the graveyard.
Treasure, you say? How much treasure?
Great, great treasure.
I don't have space for her right now. An intriguing proposition. You know where this treasure can be found?
The tomb. Dragomir's tomb. with the graves. The district of graves.
I'm afraid we have to help our friend here. Yes, you mentioned. I'd like to help you, but I'm finding you a bit beyond help from anything that's less than divine in nature. Good luck finding your way to Dragomir's tomb. Hopefully just stay here and I can pick her up later.
Hello,
I don't recall seeing your face in here before. Strangers aren't exactly welcome in these parts.
Isn't that odd for an inn? Strangers must come through here all the time.
It is an odd time. Strangers can be dangerous if one is not careful. You wish something?
Slaves being did I hear about that? Looking to dispose of some coin. No, I'm looking to gain coin, actually. Yeah, did we hear about this? I've heard of slaves being moved about the slums at night, some to this tavern. Do you know anything about that?
I do not know what you speak of. I know nothing of slaves.
Perhaps some coin would loosen your tongue.
Coin is always welcome. You will find the copper coronay able to fulfill your needs, whether drink, rest, or other sorts of entertainment.
Other sorts of entertainment? What are you talking about?
Oh, one is always able to provide entertainment.
Things like companionship, perhaps, or gambling on battles, and other things.
Companionship? That sounds interesting. Tell me more.
Very well. You look like one who might appreciate such entertainments. There is more to my little place than meets the eye.
Yoshimo says, of course there is. Isn't there always?
Go to the fellow by the door on the far wall and tell him I said to let you in. Talk to Frankie, or perhaps Madame Nin, if you wish to partake and enjoy.
Shahira says, a thoroughly despicable man, and an equally despicable place. This is the sort of thing that comes naturally with civilization, it seems. The proprietor of the Copper Coronet has given me permission to enter the back rooms of his inn. I wonder what sorts of secret and illegal services the man is offering back there.
Well, it's probably prostitutes, you know. What else could it be?
He did mention some other things.
You are back, I see.
You wish something else?
I didn't catch your name the first time. I am Minsk.
Yes. Well, I am Lieutenant, proprietor of the Copper Coronet, if you will. Welcome.
Perhaps I could see what services you have available?
The Copper Coronet aims to please.
Coronet?
But you must speak to Bernard if you wish to purchase something.
I've been saying it wrong the whole time. Coronet?